ITBC student. Now, that is the youngest, baddest uploader who has stepped foot and touched buttons on this thing and has made total sense. And I tell you something, I've seen a lot of them come and go. A YTBC student has now graduated into the midst of the masters.
What up, everybody who talks boxing, comments about boxing, and makes boxing videos. Another video from the car, driving. This is going to be a little bit more of a regular occurrence, just because, like I said, this is the time that I got. And this is a video that I actually meant to make a couple days ago, but I was just so disgusted with that Malik Scott performance on Saturday. And then, you know, the absurd things being said about Luis Ortiz being exposed and Terrence Crawford ducking this guy that he obviously would beat. You know, just been a little bit preoccupied with the time I do got to make videos. But now I'm going to give you my honest assessment of the Danny Garcia versus Samuel Vargas fight. So Danny Garcia put on a very good performance. Kudos to him. He looked very good there in the ring. He looked like he belonged there. And he gave us a very impressive TKO victory over Samuel Vargas. Samuel Vargas just had no answers for him. So if we are really honest with ourselves, though, you know, Samuel Vargas was nothing more than a confidence boost. Nothing more than kinder to ignite, or tinder, whatever. Yeah, tinder. Sorry, I haven't made a bonfire in probably a decade, but basically tinder to ignite a confidence boost. That's really all this fight really was. I mean, Samuel Vargas was ranked number 42, as opposed to Keith Thurman's last opponent, who was Sean Porter. You know, there's no comparison. So I think it was a good fight for Danny Garcia to take, just to boost his confidence, because when he fought Paulo Malignaggi, he looked piss poor, in my opinion, and then not much better against Robert Guerrero, who has been on the decline, may I add. So, after two performances that were not really impressive, I think he kind of needed an impressive one. So, really, this was just good for him mentally. So, but as far as how does this make me see the fight against Keith Thurman, it doesn't really change how I feel about that fight. Because at the end of the day, there's just, ever since he's come to welterweight, the less than stellar competition that he fought before Vargas, he wasn't able to give, you know, impressive performances. So then he fights this guy, puts on the impressive performance, but it doesn't really tell us nothing. doesn't tell us nothing at all. And when Keith Thurman fought Robert Guerrero, he fought him at the earlier stages of Robert Guerrero's decline. So that means he fought a better Robert Guerrero than Danny Garcia did. And he looked more impressive against Robert Guerrero at that. He was able to get a knockdown on Robert Guerrero, and he beat him very convincingly. Whereas when Danny Garcia fought Robert Guerrero, most people would agree that he won, but it wasn't very convincingly. So, and he wasn't able to get a knockdown. And then Robert Guerrero himself said that Keith Thurman's jabs hurt more than Danny Garcia's hooks. And that's something to really consider, because if you really think about it, Robert Guerrero is not best friends with Keith Thurman. Keith Thurman is not the godfather of his children. These guys aren't known to hang out on their off season. So there's no reason for Robert Guerrero to be biased toward toward Keith Thurman. There's no reason. He lost to both fighters, so it's not like he beat Keith Thurman and lost to Danny Garcia and is coming up with this weird theory that he still thinks that Keith, you know what I'm saying? Like, he doesn't have animosity toward Danny Garcia that he shouldn't feel toward Keith Thurman, is what I mean by he lost to both fighters. So when it comes to Robert Guerrero, you can pretty much consider his opinion to be unbiased. There's just really no real reason why he should say that Keith Thurman hits harder than Danny Garcia. Which is weird, because I've heard some people say that they think Danny Garcia hits harder than Keith Thurman. I mean, that's your opinion. You're entitled to it. And at the end of the day, these are just opinions. But I just don't know what you would base that opinion off of, being that they do have a common opponent, and Keith Thurman put a very apparent better performance where he was able to knock down Robert Guerrero versus the performance that Danny Garcia had against Robert Guerrero, which was not very impressive. And then you take in consideration the decline, because since then Robert Guerrero got knocked out by a nobody, so there is an apparent decline that's been going on with him. You know, I just don't see how you can come to that conclusion. But everybody has the right to their own opinion, so, you know, I'm not knocking it. I just don't see it. But, you know, congratulations, Danny Garcia. You know, I am glad that he took this fight for the, you know, for the reason of getting that confidence boost, because, you know, we want him and Keith Thurman to be at their best mentally and physically. And I think right now, at this point in time, they're as a, you know, mentally, they're as good a shape as they can possibly be. They're not fighting anybody else between now and their fight. So, you know, with his impressive TKO over Vargas, and then Keith Thurman defeating Sean Porter, I mean, they both have as much momentum as they can possibly have at this point in time. And I would give the momentum edge to Keith Thurman. But we'll have to see how they look physically, because we're in November, about mid-November, and, you know, March, that's about 4.5 months away. So a lot can happen between now and then. People can get into car accidents. I'm just joking. I do think Keith Thurman legitimately was in a car accident. I don't think that was a ploy But, you know, to each their own on what their theories are on that. But, you know, a lot can happen between now and then. So we'll see how these guys look physically in about 4.5 months. See if somebody puts on weight. See if somebody looks sickly. You know, we'll have to wait and see. But I do hope that they're both at the best shape that they possibly can be physically as well. Y'all let me know what y'all think. To all my subscribers, anybody watching my videos, or if you just so happen to stumble upon this video, hope you have a wonderful and blessed day. Peace. The loot. I need my cherry pie. I want you. I want my cherry pie.